This is how to synchronize Ableton and the Midronome together. So the first thing you have to do is install the plugin, the VST plugin. And once it's installed, you can just find it in your list of plugins, grab it, and it will create a track with the plugin. So you don't want to send that to the master. You want to send that to a specific audio output that would be sent to the Midronome. So external output 3, and then you can see here, that's what I call DAW 3. So when I press play, you can see DAW 3 is playing here, and this is sent to this output, which goes to this red cable here, which is sent to the input of the Midronome. And you can see it's already working, and that's because before I've been in the setup, I've chosen input, and I've chosen this 24p. So you can either choose 24p or 24p dot dot dot. In this mode, there will be no one bar delay. Like when the Midronome is not receiving anything, it will show dot, dot, it will show the three dash, and then when I press play in the DAW, it will start syncing right away. I'm going to show the 24p mode. So just to show you, I've made this session basically with all these crazy tempo changes and time signature changes. And if I put the click on, it sounds like this. And you can hear it's going to change to 3-4. And then we're going to hear that with the metronome of the Midronome. So you can hear this is in 3-4, so that's why you need to go in the setup and change the time signature so it matches. So we have a time signature of 4-4, and this is 4-4. So it needs to match because it won't synchronize automatically. Now we can hear it in time up to the point when it changes to 3-4. So the way you sort out the time signature thing, we need to create another track. It has to be a MIDI track. And in the settings of live, you need to make sure in here that you have out Midronome commands. So on Windows, that would just be the first out Midronome, and you have the track enabled. This will give you the possibility here to select Midronome commands on channel 12. And then in the inputs, what we want is basically the plugin. And this is the MIDI sent by the plugin. And we're going to change this to in, so that it's constantly sent. And now the plugin is going to send two things. It's going to change the time signature. It's also going to change the tempo. So when I move the cursor, it changes the tempo as it moves. It just sends information to the Midronome to change its tempo. And then when I press play, it starts syncing. And then you can hear it changes the time signature. So if I mute, this is only the Ableton. And this is only the Midronome. And this is both of them together. And as you can see, they're all in sync. And then from there, if the two metronomes are in sync, that means that anything that you send from the Midronome on the MIDI outputs are also going to be in sync. And I think that's it for this video. Thank you.